there, Kim Kunkel here, owner and designer over at easydigitals.com, Photoshop backgrounds and templates for sports photographers. Today, I want to talk to you about this new set called 3D Wall of Fame template set that myself and my designer came up with for you guys, and I'm super excited to share it with you and show you how it works. So when we start out, it's going to look like this, and when we're finished, it's going to look like this. So let me explain some things to you about this template set. If you purchased the entire set, you're going to have at least three folders that are zipped. You'll right click, extract all. It's a little bit different if you have a Mac, so you'll need different instructions. Once you get inside of here, you're also going to get a button that says click here for fonts needed, and you'll also get unzip instructions if you need those. You can search for unzip instructions if you do need them, but I'm sure you guys all know how to do that. So I want to show you how this is laid out. You'll get some of these templates will have what looks like a background, additional set of layers, and like this one and this one and this one. And those are because you're going to have the option to do a clipping mask with a box, or you're going to have the 3D option. And then these other ones, they're the same way, but they're just separate because for me, the design didn't work out to just lay it on top. I needed to change some things. So I had to create a separate template for that. Like this, you know, this wording was angled and this is not angled. So I just wanted to be sure and make it not too confusing. So I just made those separate. But for these, I made it the same so that it would save space for downloading and keeping on your hard drive. So let me go ahead and get back to our tutorial files. We're going to be working with this. And so here we are. I just want to go over these basic layers. We have the badge folder, which has many folders inside. We have the brush, so you can turn off the badge. We have the brush and text. We have the 3D images, and we have the box images. And then down here, we have the different backgrounds. So you could have a dark background, or you can even do a jersey texture. And that's a good one to use this color change on. So I double click that, and then this box comes up, and you can have colorize on or off, and you can change the color to match your needs. Or if you turn on colorize, then it's just a tint of that color. So it's basically one hue with a lot of different shading. So I like to use colorize for these situations. And another thing you can use this with is the dark or the light. If you turn on colorize, you're gonna get a tint for these. You can increase the saturation, and then you can have a slight tint. Okay, so I'm gonna turn those off, and I'm gonna come back to my light stadium. And I'm going to show you how it works to add in these pictures. So I'm going to open my first photo. Oh, first thing, let's go ahead and turn off the box images for now. File, open, and I'm going to come to my photo. Okay, now this is going to go over here to the left. So this says SO, your photo here, which stands for smart object. So I'm going to double click this, click OK, and I'm just going to drag my image in. And it's really small because it's a stock photo. Yours will, it might come in too big or too small. So you just need to drag those edges out or push them in and press enter. Then you close this and it immediately goes into place. Then you have all these layers on top that you can turn off or on, depending on what effect you want to go for. And you do the exact same thing over here. You'll double click on this image. You'll add your photo in. Oop, let's see, drag this out, drag this photo in, drag out the edges. Oh, try it again. Pressing Control 0. I'm gonna get good and zoomed in here so we can see his expression on this one. I say yes, I want to close it, and there it is. So that is how you add the smart objects. It's pretty easy. I just love smart objects used in this way. So if we don't want to do that, there's another way we can do it. If it distorts your photo too much, for example, you may not want to do that. So let me show you the other option. I'll turn that off and we'll just clip it. So we're going to use this one to just clip it. So file, open. I'm going to open my image and I'm going to drag it in, pull it out. I'm pressing shift so that it keeps the aspect ratio. And voila, there it is. What if you want to change the aspect and you want it to match the angles of this? You just come over to your little square here and you're going to press down your control key and you're going to drag this out to match the angle of the photo. So I'm going to take this one down. As you can see, I'm just matching the angles here and over. And then press enter, and then you can just arrow it wherever you want it. So that's how you add the photos for the 3D. And it's going to be similar for the boxes, but with the boxes, you can change the sizes of the boxes. You can add more boxes. You can copy boxes. You have lots of options here because you may have lots of different photos and you may need them to be a certain way. So I wanted to make sure that you could change this in any way. So I went ahead and added these extra options to just have square photos so that you would be able to do anything you wanted. So let's say you wanted, you know, three photos and one really small one here. You can do that with this set. So it's the same as the clipping mask version. Can't get this exactly right. You can zoom in on these and get them exactly right and make sure they measure up. But you do it the exact same way. So you're going to come in, you're going to take your photo. I'm going to make sure I have my left photo here. And I'm going to file, open, grab this, drag it in. It's going to go right into place. Make it whatever size you want, then you just push it around with your right and left arrows. I'm going to close that. These also have effects to them. It has a bevel. So if you decide that you want to change the bevel, you just double click that. Did not mean to do a color overlay. So it has a bevel here and you can just adjust this. Right now the depth is 164 and you can play with this, make it adjust any way you want. It's totally changeable. So that is how you add a photo to the 3D Wall of Fame. Next, I'm going to show you how to adjust the badge. So stay tuned.